Our next guest is Ron Browning, who owns and operates a second bed and breakfast in Havre de Grace. Welcome, Ron.
Thank you for me being here.
Ron, how about explaining the name and how you arrived at the name of your bed and breakfast?
Well, La Clé d'Or Guesthouse is in French. And a friend of mine had recommended the name because the concierge at the fine hotels in Paris wear what are called La Clé d'Or on their lapels. And so she recommended that for a fine bed and breakfast in Havre de Grace.
Great, great story.
Yes,
thank
that's
you.
How it came about.
Ron, when was your house built?
The house was built in 1868, and it was built upon the foundations of a house that preceded it in 1839.
And who built it, and what's the history?
It was built by Henry Harrison Hopkins, who was a pharmacist, born 1840, died 1900. His father owned the house across the street, Dr. Thomas Hopkins. And Dr. Thomas Hopkins was a general practitioner of medicine. He also served in the Maryland General Assembly during the American Civil War. Both of the two men were cousins of Johns Hopkins, who, of course, is famous for the university and hospital in Baltimore.
Wow, great, great provenance, I guess.
Yes,
you'd say.
Great provenance. The architecture of the house is called Second Empire. Now, Second Empire, that means the Second Empire of France that was under Louis Napoleon III, and he was the Emperor of France between 1851 and 1871. The style of the house includes such things as mansard roofs like you see in Paris, and also the lay of the slate roof was done in a design called Flemish Bond.
Well, you told me at one time the windows or something are all different. What was that all about?
It's in a very eclectic style that came in vogue right after the Civil War, part of the Gilded Age. And a lot of the windows, for instance, do not match. They have bullseyes, corbels, window boxes. In fact, one of the windows has what look like the doors to a cuckoo clock over it.
Wow. That's interesting. How about describing the inside of the house, how many rooms and stuff?
Well, the house is actually a three-story house. It has a full livable attic, and it has a partial basement. There are 17 rooms. Around it, it has a attached two-car garage. It also has a bricked-in, a wall that was built by the previous owners around a boxwood garden that is entered by wrought iron gates. And the house is, of course, situated on Union Avenue. On Union Avenue, that's the main thoroughfare through the historic district of Havre de Grace. And if Havre de Grace had become the capital of the United States, like it was supposed to back in 1790, that would have been the route for the presidential inauguration parades.
When did you buy the house, and who did you buy it from?
I bought it in 1994. It was a foreclosure on a bank vice president who had embezzled some money from the bank, and I bought it at auction.
And he had done a number of upgrades, didn't he?
The two-car garage, the brick wall around the boxwood garden, yes, he had done quite a bit.
Well, how about describing the collections you have inside your house?
Well, a lot of the collections are from my travels around the world. Some of the things are just collections that I began and have accumulated. There are such things as Staffordshire, Delftware from Holland, Ruby Flash glassware. There's Railroadiana, meaning railroad collectibles, and there are Civil War things. So just a number of things.
And one of the things I think is an outstanding feature, which we'll show in a minute, are the crystal chandeliers you have throughout the house.
There are 17 Strauss crystal from Austria chandeliers in the house that conveyed upon the sale of the house. So they were bought by the previous owner, The banker.
So if I'm a guest at your place, I kind of can go through and see a lot of different things.
There are a
that
lot
you've
of
collected
things.
Worldwide. Is that
yes,
correct?
Yes, that's actually correct. And there's a lot of artwork in the house. For instance, there is a mural in the kitchen, which was painted by Valerie Lloyd, a local artist of the Susquehanna River Flats, featuring the lighthouse and the Bayou Hotel.
Well, let's take a little tour through your house now.
Okay. This is the exterior of the house. And it shows you, for instance, the little clock doorway above the one dormer. This is the entrance to the gardens, and you see the brick wall and the wrought iron gate that goes into the boxwood gardens. Here, for instance, is the patio inside the gardens, and there is a large deck and such, many flowering shrubs and flowering trees.
Now that looks like a great place to have a bourbon and water some evening.
If you want to do that, you're more than welcome to do so.
Okay.
Now we're inside of the house, and this is the formal dining room. You see the Strauss crystal chandelier. Also, there's the fireplace, and there are some antiques in the room. Here it was decorated for Mardi Gras, and you see our porcelain doll collection in some fantastic costumes.
And when a new season comes along, you change the whole interior decor.
We change the whole decor for the various holidays.
Good.
Inside the formal dining room is this piece, which is a Baroque cabinet. And that Baroque cabinet dates to about 1880, 1890. It's called a closed china. The parlor has a wonderful alcove that is just a very neat feature and beautifully wallpapered. And here you have a piece that is a mahogany secretary. It was built in 1830 in Chatham, New York. Here's one of the examples of a Strauss crystal chandelier. This one is the one in the parlor.
And that's one of your biggest chandeliers, isn't it? It's certainly my favorite.
Yes, it is. And those crystals are all from Austria, and then it is actually gilded.
Wow.
In the what used to be the kitchen, which is now our breakfast room, there are ceiling-high cabinets, which are full of such things as Amari ware from Japan, and also one of the cabinets features B&O railroad china. That one, for instance, and also you see a portrait of the house that was done by Carolyn Jasper, an original oil painting.
Good.
Now, this is a place setting of B&O railroad china that was used on the railroads during the dining cars for passenger service.
And you have a lot of place settings of that.
And I have actually used the place settings, especially when guests have requested such. I had a lady whose father, for instance, served on the B&O railroad.
Wow. And you have a lot of place settings. Do you have other pieces of the B&O, like creamers and things like that?
Yes, I do. Yes,
oh,
I do.
Oh, that's wonderful. Let's go upstairs now.
Okay, let's do so. Here is one of the bedrooms. This is called the Rochambeau. It's named after the Count de Rochambeau, who came through Havre de Grace during the Revolutionary War. You see the Strauss crystal chandelier, for instance, some of the bedroom furniture. The furniture is French provincial. The wallpaper is Napoleonic. And here, continuing through the room, you see there's a fireplace, some wonderful antiques, some mirrors and such. This is another of the bedrooms. This one is our de Grasse bedroom, and it is done in Eastlake. You'll notice over the bed is a partial teaster, which actually is a piece from an organ. The wallpaper is, again, Napoleonic and a Strauss crystal chandelier. And you could continue around the room, and you see, again, more of the Eastlake furnishings. This room is our Lafayette. The Lafayette is usually used with weddings, and this room has a wonderful southern canopied bed. And also it has an adjoining sunroom with two banks of windows that overlook the garden. It has a kidney-shaped couch that is actually called a Jean Harlow couch from the 1930s. And continuing throughout the room, you see some of the antiques, including an 1830s mahogany dresser.
I personally like your temple rubbings from Vietnam.
There are temple rubbings there that I got in Bangkok, Thailand. Yes, there are.
Okay.
This is our hunt room, which features various decoys and such. It also has, for instance, some militaria in it. There is a red coat from a British soldier in the Black Watch. It probably dates to about 1880.
Very good. Thank you for your tour.
You're quite welcome.
If a guest was coming to your place, as I did coming into your home, I can't see it all. You've got so many lovely things in there to take a look at. What's your favorite thing you got in your house?
Well, one of the favorite things that I have is some of the Delftware. And some of those Delftware pieces date all the way back to when I was a teenager, just beginning my collection.
My favorite piece in the house is a handout you gave me, which lists what all you have in each room. And so if I'm a guest and you give me that handout, I can really take my time and look the place over.
Well, that what we tried to do there was try to enhance the visit for the for our various guests and make their visit wonderful.
Well, thank you, Ron, for being our guest today and sharing your lovely home.
Well, thank you very much, Joe, for inviting me.
And a special thanks to you, our viewing audience, for being with us. We hope you'll join us again on Historic Harford.